Welcome to Analytics with Nags. This is the first video of this channel and it's all going to be an introduction video. In this video, we are going to see how to install a Power BI. Before installing, I would like to start with introduction to Power BI. A Power BI is nothing but a business intelligence reporting tool. It's used to create visualization, reports, and dashboards. The dashboard in terms, if you have multiple reports, one or two reports, and you can see it in a single page along with the key performance indicators or any other gadgets and anything you are monitoring as part of your business, that is called your dashboard. This software is provided by Microsoft, and there are other vendors who provides a business intelligence tool like Tableau and ClickView. Let's see more about Power BI. This is the architecture of Power BI, where you find a left-hand side a Power BI desktop, and in the middle you have a Power BI services. Let us focus only on Power BI desktop for a few videos, and later we can see about Power BI services. As I pointed out, we are going to see a Power BI desktop, which is nothing but authoring tool for creating your reports. One of the important factors about Power BI desktop is it's free. And another important factor is like you can able to connect 80 plus sources. When you say the sources, it can be a database or an Excel or any other kind of data sources like Azure. Say for example, consider a retail shop who is having his point of sale system in the database, and he may have the customer information in the Excel. So he wants to analyze both these data, one from database, another from Excel, together in the reporting tool. So this is the main advantage of going for a business intelligence reporting tools, where you can integrate data from multiple sources and you can unify the reports in a single place. That is the main feature of your reporting tools. Another thing what you can do in the Power BI desktop is you can transform and edit and modify the data. So in future videos, you can see further about it, how you can modify and transform. The last thing you can do in Power BI desktop is like modeling. Let's see by quick demo how to install a Power BI desktop. Go to Google and type Power BI desktop free download. As I mentioned, it is free. So click on the first link that appears in the search results. Then scroll down a little. Don't confuse with the many options available here. Focus on the first option. Don't click on the first one. Go to the advanced download options. Scroll down a little. Just check the system requirements here. It accepts Windows 10, Windows 8, with Windows 8.1. All these operating systems are supported. Ensure that you have these operating systems. Then click on download. So based on your system configuration, whether it can be a 64-bit or 32-bit system, you choose appropriate option, then click on next. So as soon as you press next, it starts downloading. I already downloaded the file. just canceling. In your case, once you download, go to the file path where it got downloaded, double click on it. Then it's a simple installation by clicking on next default options. So it will ask for create desktop shortcut. Click on say yes, and it will take few minutes, almost 5 minutes it will complete. That's all. So now it got finished. Click on finish to launch the Power BI desktop. It will take a few minutes to launch. In background, it is launching. So in this screen, you can see like sign in to collaborate and share content. This is for Power BI service. Once you have developed, you can deploy it in Power BI service. That is why it's mentioning sign up for 60 days. As I said, Power BI desktop is completely free, but when you want to collaborate, they are giving for few days. So ignore this page for now. That's all, guys. So we're done with the installation of Power BI Desktop. In future videos, we will see how to load data into Power BI Desktop and to create quick dashboard. If you like this channel, if you like this video, subscribe it and share with your friends. Do remember that data is your asset. Thanks for watching.